This is the DT360 ARGB display high performance all-in-one CPU cooler. And the folks at CPS have been so excited about this product that they introduced it to us and sponsored this video for us to introduce it to you. Stick around as we get to know the DT360 a little bit better right here, right now on Robeytech. We always love getting to learn more about brands that we're not familiar with here in the United States, and CPS is one of them. Although to be more specific, even though it says CPS on the box, we're getting to know them by another name, and that name is PCCooler. As a brand, PCCooler has air coolers, AIOs, fans, power supplies, PC cases, and more. And when we say more, I mean that they have PCIe riser cables, RGB extensions, and a variety of thermal pastes. This video is going to be more of an overview of this bad boy right here, the DT360, so we'll be showing you some light performance information in isolation, of course, but we'll be doing an in-depth full review in the near future. Now, let's get to know the DT360 starting with the price. At the time of making this video, this AIO can be found at Newegg and Amazon for around $250, but CPS is offering a promotional price of $219 at the time of launch. This price positions it as a premium AIO, which seems to be the aim, and aesthetically, this thing does look like $1 million. The water block and display have CNC machined and anodized aluminum shells, and with the options in white or black, this AIO really is designed to fit inside of a showcase build nicely. Speaking of the display, the DT360's display is actually magnetic, so if you want to take it off of the pump and move its location, whether that's someplace inside or outside of the PC case, you can totally do that. Now, one quick note on the screen's mobility before moving on to the specs, and this may be super obvious to state, but this display does need to be plugged in via USB. It is not secretly or wirelessly just can get power anywhere. The DT360 comes with an internal USB 2.0 cable, but if you want to use the display outside of the case, you're going to need to provide your own cable for that. A standard USB Type-C cable should absolutely do the trick. As for the specs of the display, we're looking at a 3.4-inch 480p IPS display with a 60Hz refresh rate. The DT360's display allows users to customize its appearance with their favorite animated GIFs, video clips, or picture files. All of this, plus the addition of system monitoring, can be modified with the DT360's accompanying software. But let's say you're seeing the design and thinking, Roby? Well, it looks cool, but how well does it work as a CPU cooler? Give us the specs, man. Well, since we're in the neighborhood of the pump head, the DT360 utilizes a motor with a ceramic bearing shaft and sleeve that can achieve maximum speeds of 2600 RPM. Give or take, of course. This is paired with a copper cold plate, a 27 millimeter thick radiator with extra channels for extra cooling potential, and a trio of fans designed to take care of the heat at high speeds. Now, these fans are rated to spin up to 3000 RPM and produce up to 83 CFM at a static pressure of 5.7 millimeter H2O. Running under full CPU load, we recorded the F7 X120 fans averaging a little over 67 decibels and just under 51 decibels while gaming. However, if you're after a more quiet operation, the fans have switches on the back of them to reduce their speeds, which can bring the noise levels down. For reference, Amaral had the fans set to high out of the box. Now, before we move on from the fans, I want to point out two things. First is the RGB design. If you're someone who likes a tasteful amount of RGB, say, the DT360's fans provide two thin RGB halos that could fit into a build with minimalistic lighting. Now, the second thing I want to point out is that these fans are interconnected and come pre-installed on the radiator. So if you're fine leaving fans on high, the DT360 is ready to install out of the box. And that brings us to installation and compatibility. On the AMD side, the DT360 supports CPUs on both the AM4 and AM5 platforms. So basically, if you're using a Ryzen chip, you are absolutely golden there. With the AMD mounting brackets, users will tie into the pre-existing backplate on AMD motherboards after removing the stock clips. As for Intel, compatibility ranges from LGA 115X all the way up to 1851. If Team Blue is your platform of choice, the DT360 supports early Intel processors all the way up to Core Ultra 200S CPUs. As for the installation, installers will use the included metal backplate, make adjustments for their socket of choice, and then secure it in place with the Intel mounting bracket. Now, just in case you're wondering, after we talked about the PCCooler branded thermal paste, yes, there is actually a tube of PCCooler EX90 thermal paste included with the DT360. But That's not all. The DT360 also comes with a USB 2.0 Type-C to motherboard cable for the screen, 12 mounting screws for the radiator, as well as a fan and ARGB hub, just in case you have more devices than ports on your actual motherboard. So now that we know just about everything there is to know about the CPS PCCooler DT360, and yes, it does like long walks on the beach too, so boom, let's take a look at the performance. Now, just a few comments here before we get into the data. Thing number one is that because this is an overview, we're gonna be looking at it very lightly from a performance standpoint, and we're gonna be looking at it in isolation. Think of this as like an appetizer, but if you're hungry to know more about how the DT360 stacks up against other AIOs and for more in-depth data, don't worry, we're gonna do a more comprehensive review later on, so make sure you like, subscribe, and hit those notification bells here at both Robeytech and Robeytech Live so you don't miss it when it drops. Now moving on to thing number two. All of our testing that we do on AIOs is done the same way to keep the science sound, even for our overviews. We test on both AMD and Intel CPUs that represent what we would typically think of an every gamer system to be like. With all that in mind, let's take a look at our full CPU load data. This is data collected running our 14700K and 7700X test benches at 100% to collect thermal data. Starting with Intel under full CPU load, we saw the DT360 hold temperature averages just a hair below 80 degrees Celsius. We switched over to AMD, we saw the DT360 hold an average temperature just below 86 degrees Celsius under full CPU load. And now that we have a few broad strokes of what the DT360 is, its features, and a bit about how it performs, we're gonna close out this overview of the CPS PCCooler DT360. To recap, the DT360 features an aluminum design and subtle RGB to complement its 480p detachable IPS display. Aside from the aesthetic features, the DT360 has a high-performance pump, a 360mm radiator, and a trio of fans with multiple speed adjustments for users to tailor to their needs. There's a lot going on with this AIO, and I cannot wait to dig in on our full review and share the rest of the data we gathered on it, but we wanted to make an introduction right here. Again, we want to say a huge thank you to CPS for sponsoring this video and providing us with the DT360 to share with you today. But as always, we now need to know what you think. What do you think about having a detachable display on an AIO? What do you think about the RGB on these fans? What PC case would you actually pair this with? And is there something that we touched on in this overview that you'd love for us to dig in deeper in our full review? Let us know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. And if you want to continue the conversation, talk about the questions we asked in this video, or ask questions of your own, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. It's an amazing place to talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts about stuff just like this. And hey, you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us on Robeytech on all your favorite social media platforms. And if you've made it this far, I want to say a huge thank you for sticking with me throughout this video. I look forward to seeing you on the next one.